As we consider lawmakers' constitutional mandate during this 30-day session, we want to focus first on the budget and our state's relationship with the oil and gas industry. According to reporting from Capital and Maine journalist Jerry Redfern, nearly 40% of this year's general fund budget comes from oil and gas. The governor and elected officials certainly support that industry and the vital bump that it gives to the state budget. But New Mexico voters consistently say they want action on climate change, though the legislature has rarely delivered. I want to ask you guys, will this year be different? Will there be action on climate?
So, Gwen, can I ask which voters are we talking about? Are we talking about northern New Mexico voters? Are we talking about southern New Mexico voters? Because I think the relationship that New Mexicans have with oil and gas and with the sense that they want a safe, healthy state with clean air, clean water, beautiful land is going to differ based on that. We have consistently seen bills to regulate the oil and gas industry despite, you know, the split in Republicans and Democrats fail in the legislature. And that's because I think we all understand that oil and gas is, its future is connected to the future of New Mexico. And all of these things that the governor and our legislative bodies want to do to improve the state rests on this industry and the success of this industry. So is it smart to try to interrupt that? You tell me.
I mean, we frame it as a conflict all the time. And Lujan Grisham said, we are demonstrating that a healthy environment and a strong economy are not in conflict. But she sort of said we can do these things at the same time. And yet, Representative Deborah Saragnana has introduced a bill that would stop new oil and gas operations within a mile of any school facility. I heard her on KUNM the other day say she has no idea what the governor's doing about this. They're not talking about it. So there is a disconnect there. And as we showed earlier, the governor pushed back against environmental protesters just a little bit, saying New Mexico is a clean energy leader and has passed policies cutting oil and gas pollution. This session, though, what energy or pollution bills have been introduced, aside from Saragnana's, that you guys think we should keep an eye on? Is there anything that you are looking at, Tripp?
I mean, I want to say to this larger issue about New Mexico and the budget, I just want to point this out that we can talk about like oil and gas and climate and up. And the thing I want to say is that people can be against oil and gas, but they need to understand that oil and gas revenue pays for all these programs that benefit New Mexicans. And by which I mean Medicaid, which is the health insurance and program. So if you start pulling back on this industry, I think you're going to see an effect on the budget. And I want to say that really loudly, because I'm someone who does actually think that the world has to take the climate thing is real. At the same time, New Mexico is number two in oil production, and it's like a golden goose right now. And all this money is coming into the state. And at some point, this money is going to run out. And, there's going to be a deep, I have covered legislative sessions where they were not $3.5 billion surplus, but maybe
That's
a
right.
billion dollars
we
under.
We have been, you and I remember, and a lot of us who've been covering this remember when there wasn't enough money to go around. But I want to, Capital in Maine published several stories last year about the state's struggles to enforce our existing regulations. The Environment Department's request for $6 million to increase employee pay to keep people from quitting was not considered by the Legislative Finance Committee. And last year, we hosted a panel in this studio following the end of the session when very few environmental bills passed, and the most significant ones were vetoed by the governor. Are legislators actually doing anything to properly regulate this industry? And are they using any of the money from industry to focus on mitigation of greenhouse gases or adaptation to climate change? Are we seeing this? Jessica, are you looking at any of these?
Yeah, so let me take a step back and just say that I think there are certain proposals in this legislature that are common sense, right? No, we don't want oil and gas operations near schools. I think we can all kind of agree on that. But there are other things like enforcing a 98% gas capture rule across the state, which, you know, is also seems common sense. But I think part of this conversation also has to be more about what is industry doing itself to regulate itself? What kind of technologies, research and development programs are they putting into place to make sure that they are complying with state laws and regulations, but also going above and beyond that? Now,
let me interrupt you just briefly to say, we have seen just in the past few weeks what happens when industry regulates itself, and Boeing has had a spectacular failure in an industry that people are now saying isn't regulated enough. So there's going to be pushback on that idea.
Well, yes. And you know, if you talk to industry leaders, they say, we're doing what we can. But if you're talking to New Mexicans, maybe they do want to see a little bit more. And if that's what we're reaching for, great. But back to your point, which is how much of that revenue that we're seeing is going to actually support those efforts. And if you talk to Secretary Kenny, he'll say, obviously not enough, given that he keeps asking for monies to support the efforts that they're doing. If you talk to the Oil Conservation District, they need more too as well. But again, I think that the state of New Mexico's response to that is, well, let's talk about raising royalties, which is also part of this package, right, to further support that work. And again, that's a burden on an industry that's already supporting so much of this state.
Yeah, good point. But bigger picture, too, it's a budget session. Every agency, every department in government is coming to the table with their operating budgets. Is climate even a top 10 concern among lawmakers right now?
You know, that's a great question, because this is a budget session. You mentioned every agency going through. I mean, honestly, we have a lot of vacancy rates out there in a lot of state agencies. So there are going to be questions of, you know, lawmakers will be focused on the budget and vacancy rates and how much they need each agency needs, and the conversation around do we need to increase worker pay to actually lure people to state agencies? I will say it's really interesting. It's 2024. 2019 was Governor Lujan Grisham's first session, and that was a huge session when they passed the Clean Energy Act. I can't remember what the exact name of it was. So there was a lot of hope and whatnot that was happening in 2019. I think at this point, there are arguments over, Jessica, is it produced water? Is that what it's called? Yeah. Coming out of, that's where some of the conversation is going to be, which is, hey, look, we've got all this water here that we have excess. Maybe we can use it for whatever. Hydrogen. How do we get, you know, is it green? Is it blue hydrogen? That's going to be a really interesting thing. Is it top 10? Probably top 10, but it's not going to be, like, next session, I expect a lot of these conversations to really dominate.
Yeah. The governor talked about several economic development initiatives. If we're not going to live on oil and gas, water, what else is there? That's always the big pressure. The state has already accomplished several things, including bringing in companies from Australia, Europe, and Asia. But what other economic development ideas or initiatives are you hearing about that we should keep tabs on this year? Jessica?
Well, they're not new. Obviously, our investment in the film industry continues to be of interest across the state. We look at what's happening. The governor in her speech announced an investment to build a full service film industry infrastructure. And in Las Cruces, you're looking at 828 Film Studios investment in an old what used to be an old mill in the city that will create dozens and dozens of jobs. And that's exactly what we want to see. Beyond that, renewable energies is always an area of focus for growth. And I think that the old argument is renewable going to produce enough to replace fossil fuels based industry still stands. We're also looking at manufacturing, especially in southern New Mexico. We've seen great strides with that on the small scale. But we continue to hope that tax credits and proposals coming from the governor and the legislators will help induce more growth in that area.
Can I add, one thing that's maybe off the beaten path here is actually remediation, which is there are a lot of mines, and I'm going to talk about the northwest corner of the state where you have a lot of uranium mines and stuff like this. There's a lot of federal money coming into the state in the next 2 or 3 years on all sorts of remediation, and that's going to like increase the number of jobs. And that's, so in some ways, this is a very mineral rich state. And I think that there's conversations up at the Capitol about how do we get people into remediation kind of projects, because that's going to last for a little bit of time there. That's also economic diversification, even if it's not for 7-8 decades, it's still going to be part of the diversification conversation, I think.
But we're not talking about 8 decades. We're talking about 30 days that the state constitution says we have to hammer out these. Part of the work of this session involves reaching an agreement between what legislators want and the governor's dream budget. They're all politicians, but they have very different political realities. So how hard is it going to be in this year with record revenues and disagreements about how much to save and crafting a budget and do everything else that the governor laid out in her speech?
Go ahead, Jessica.
I mean, I just want to jump in and make one point, which is we've been talking about oil and gas as the driver of the state economy. But one thing we haven't said is oil and gas is a boom and bust industry. And we know this in New Mexico. We have experienced it firsthand. And, you know, even with the outlook that this current uptick in production that puts us at number two in the nation, right, in the world, will maybe last 30, 40, 50 years. And when you're talking about budgets and long-term investments, that's not a really long time.
It's not. Jessica, Tripp, we have about 15 seconds left here. Is a 30-day session enough time to turn around the entire history of our state's economic picture?
No, but I will say that there's going to be discussions about creating endowment funds for state agencies,
right,
in addition to the budget and the operating reserves because of this boom-bust cycle. We've got early childhood development, which has got multi-billion dollars, which you live off the interest. So that's going to be part of the budget conversation.
Trust funds. We're going to watch that.
Yep.
Thanks again to our panelists. We'll be back again for one final legislative preview in just a moment.